ibon tuoro nomuhang bune nonen ote.
It's on. Hi everyone. You guys ready? Let's do this.
Assalamualaikum and good evening everyone. Welcome back to PD Talk Series 3.0.
And now I would like to give a warm welcome to our pretty, gorgeous and lovely advisor.
And don't forget to give a big applause to our guest, Bapak-bapak Monica.
Bapak-bapak.
Okay, Atira, if you realize that some of us didn't know what is virtual tour, can you give some overview to them, Atira?
A virtual tour is a simulation of an actual place, such as tourist destination, using sequential video or still image. Ada multimedia components such as music, sound effects and floor layouts and so on, so might be used as well. Virtual tour ni juga contribute to the creation of realistic picture of reality, Nabila.
Wow. Thank you, Atira, for the great explanation. As you know that we cannot do travel nowadays due to COVID-19. So I think this virtual tour might help for those who dying to travel.
Now we are going to introduce Bapa Bob a little bit.
Bapa Bob is tour consultant and tour guide. Bapa Bob was graduated at Polytechnic Syahid with diploma in tourism and travel management and also bachelor in tourism management. He currently studying master in tourism communication at Syahid Postgraduate School. Not only that, Bapa Bob also has certification in master trainer level 6, event organizer national professional certification board, travel consultant and tourist guide national professional certification board. Moreover, Bapak Bob also was broadcaster and has his own channel on YouTube called Travel Talk with Bob Monica. In addition, now he is a lecturer at Polytechnic Syahid in Jakarta. Ini adalah foto-foto Bapak Bob semasa mengembara satu dunia when he was a tour guide. And this is when Bapak Bob as broadcaster and also as a lecturer.
Without further ado, I will pass the mic to our talkative moderators.
Yay!
Thank you.
Thank you. What an amazing background from our Tom Cruise Indonesia, ya, Lisa?
Ya, betul. Yes. Jarang sekali ya kita dapat ketemu sama Tom Cruise dari Indonesia ini.
Itu baru sikit lakonannya yang depan-depan tadi tu. Siapa yang tengok tadi tu? Kalau nak tengok lebih lagi boleh follow Bapak Bob dekat Instagram.
Yes.
Kita boleh tengok ya.
Okay. Bapak Bob, how's the condition in Indonesia right now? Is it still lockdown?
Lockdown. Been extend from the 20 July to the 2nd of August.
Oh.
Extend lagi.
So, Bapak-bapak, since we are currently still in the middle of pandemic, virtual tour is getting more attention and becoming a trend. And as what we are doing right now is somewhat same with virtual tour. So, and using virtual reality, virtual tour is made possible by applying some sensors to promote the most realistic experience to people. In fact, in Malaysia, virtual tour is actively hosted by tourism destination, and I personally has joined one of the virtual tour hosted by tourism destination, which is Zoo Melaka. During the virtual tour, I saw the giraffe, the tiger, the snakes, but of course I prefer to see it face to face because I like to touch them, and sometimes I wish
with
I can
the giraffe.
Yes, but Bapak Bob, sometimes I wish I want to be there with the tiger. I want to be in the cage.
Syikin.
Wah.
Ini nanti tajuk tu makan awak.
Ya, dia mau masuk jadi moderator kalau kena makan ni Syikin.
Because Tiger and me has a bond, Bapak Bo. When we see each other, yes. We cannot
deny that lah.
Yes, I want to be there to feel the real excitement, Bapak Bob. So, I want to know, how is the reception tour, virtual tour in Indonesia? Is it well accepted?
Yes, actually, virtual tour, it's one of the alternative solutions right now when we are in lockdown. Because everyone want to travel, gitu ya. Yes. Travel is not... like a premier needs right now, yeah. It used to be a third year, but now it's a premier needs for everybody. And everybody is so busy and with everything, so mereka cari harus pesiar lah, rekreasi lah, relax sedikit gitu. Tapi sekarang lockdown, totally lockdown pada saat ini. Jadi virtual tour bisa jadi alternatif. One of the alternative, ya, untuk memenuhi kerinduan untuk jalan-jalan traveling itu, seperti itu. Di Indonesia juga sudah mulai berkembang.
Iya. Yeah. Jadi antara virtual tour yang di-offerkan di Indonesia itu banyak sekali ya, Pak. Karena saya lihat ada yang wellness, ada yang heritage, culture tour, even culinary for that matter, ya.
Yeah.
Jadi kalau tentang wisata nature itu, bagaimana ya dijalankan itu? Karena data itu atau connection di dalam national park atau begitu ya, bagaimana mereka boleh ada akses di situ ya?
That's the problem about virtual tour because as you know, Indonesia 17,000 islands. All the facility and everything's the tower ya itu tidak merata. Jadi in some area they have a very good signal gitu ya. Dan di area yang lain tidak. So virtual tour they have a different type of virtual tour.
Right.
Yeah. Di Indonesia. Wow. One is been recorded, the other one is not. So if you do a live virtual tour, it's going to be different in some areas. Yeah.
Oh, ada juga yang pre-record ya, Pak ya?
Ada yang pre-record.
Jadi itu bukan live. Jadi kalau begitu nggak bisa tanya soalan apa-apa.
Kalau yang live, gitu, yang live syaratnya harus punya very good connections, right, 4G, right. 5G, gitu ya.
Betul.
4G, 5G. Even 3G is not enough because di channelnya gitu, di kanalnya itu, there's a voice, there's a pictures, the moving pictures. It's not only a static pictures. So it's going to be difficult if you want to use it as this is technically actually to be a virtual live virtual tour.
Oh, yeah. Jadi Bapak kiranya kalau di sana kan virtual tour yang live itu harganya lagi mahal ke, atau gimana Bapak?
Dibanding dengan yang biasa, virtual tour relatif lebih murah. Gitu ya, relatif lebih murah. Some of them sell for about mungkin in rupiah itu 50.000, 150.000 gitu ya. Ada yang 250.000. For the special one, I have a friend who he's in Yogyakarta, but special, yeah. It's a very niche one. This one for volcanoes tour, yeah.
Wow,
volcano tour.
Volcanoes.
Oh.
I think his client is international wide. He's very active in volcanoes tour.
Wow, kita harus join nih. Ada linknya Pak. Mau.
Nanti saya tinggal sama dia.
Ya, mau.
Bisa di-share.
Volcano Indonesia.
Karena itu kalau real life pun aku nggak pergi tuh. Takut.
Aku menetes. Dari jauh aja ya, Mekam.
Usually the volcano is for scientists. For scientists. Sebenarnya dia sudah lakukan itu, tapi because of the situation, the pandemic, it's more famous. Biasanya orang dari luar negeri harus datang ke Indonesia Now, wow. Karena pandemic, malah lebih terkenal, lebih banyak request dari luar negeri.
Betul tuh, Bapak. Seperti
betul tuh, Bapak.
As you mentioned before, itu. Bapak, because of this transition from before pandemic and also after the pandemic, we see that the demand of this virtual tour are slowly increasing, right? So I believe this is because of the travelers around the world are desperate for an experience, as you mentioned before, to replace their holiday that had to be cancelled or the trip they had, they hope to take their holiday. But today, we notice that many individuals are taking the opportunity, peluang ini, to host the virtual toursnya. Walaupun regardless they have license or non-license.
Yeah.
So hence the interpretation of this could be different and questionable. Because orang kan lain-lain ya, Pak. Jadi bila mereka interpret satu tempat itu,
story-nya lah, story-nya beda lah.
Story-nya beda. Jadi, so what is your opinion on this, Bapak?
The truth is, I'm not a virtual kind of, virtual tour kind of person. What I mean is like this. I'm not supporting a virtual tour to be continuous because after pandemic we have to go to the real thing.
Betul.
Because tourism, benar. Gitu ya, tourism. One of the company in tourism, you have to develop namanya economic ya, to increase economic of the locals. Right. Not virtual tour. Virtual tour is only for the professional and the operator only.
Right.
Yeah. There is no souvenirs, there is no meals, there is no accommodations. So the word experience, experience is only for a virtual tour. But virtual tour is only like a reduction of the drive. Yeah, you are the patients who've been locked down for a long time, gitu ya. You want to travel, so it's a drive reduction actually. It's only like melepaskan rindu, gitu ya. Sebenarnya.
Yeah.
Tapi yeah, it's not a real tour because sensesnya itu hanya eyes. Because five sensors ya, sensors sih, gitu ya.
Yeah, benar.
Five sensors, gitu ya. You're looking for experience, yeah. You have to know the motive of people of traveling, yeah. They look for a new knowledge, new experience, gitu ya. Touch-nya tidak ada.
Yeah.
Yeah. Actual touch. So virtual, the definition of virtual itself is almost real. Almost real. So 99.9% real is not real. Should be 100% real. So virtual tour is only an alternative, yeah, for a drive reductions. Okay, in 2019, the end of 2019, they said, oh, it's going to be, in August lah, 2020 lah.
Betul-betul.
August. I have discussions with Ibu Teti. Ibu Teti. Our estimation is 2023. Okay? Because what? Okay, 2020, the vaccines. 2021, give the vaccinations. So you have to... the economic first, the priority 2022, the 2023 is going to be normal. I already have the information from the World Tourism Organizations. In 2024, the 2024 tourism global only 41%. So if 2019 is 100%, 2024 global tourism only 41%. That's the data. Estimations.
Oh, wow. So, Bapak, as you mentioned earlier, virtual tour may not able to give us most realistic. Like you said, it almost realistic, but not realistic, right? But the only memories that we can keep during the virtual tour is screenshot. Like we can get an OOTD because people usually travel for status recognition, right?
Yes, Bapa. When I travel, I want post something.
Yes, she
wants to show off.
I want to show off.
We want to show off. show off.
The world must know.
The world must know that we've been. In past, like the whoever went to London or Paris, they have that status, you know? Like, wow, she has been to London, but the status is higher than the other, right? So how do you think that virtual tour can give us that sense of recognition?
The truth is, studying with the virtual reality, I already did that for since about 5-6 years ago, but only to upgrade my knowledge. Yeah, I use Google Street View, everything, is it? When I'm travel around the world and I have assignment to a new places, I have to study. So I open up, you know, I gather all the pictures, I gather all the videos, and I study for myself as a tour leader, as a tour manager, go abroad. So I can go to the places with some background of knowledge, not starting from zero. But now, with these conditions, I have to share it to other people. So I can have an income from it. But now, virtual tour, that's the area that a real tourist guide or tour leader cannot enter before, because you have to gain a knowledge from broadcasting. Yes. From information technology, how to use it, what kind of platform want to use, StreamYard, Zoom, Google Meet, YouTube, whether. So virtual tour is an alternative, only touching about 2 or 3 sensors, eyes, your hearing,
Sebab,
do you want to play the Musang King virtually?
Musang King?
You have to tourism, it's a people the motive of traveling and tourism, for a tour, tour is experiencing. That's the basic things. So you have to sit by yourself. Life, on the same place, the humidity of the place, more skiing. How do you feel? Celsius, under zero.
Jadi bapa kalau dari status itu gimana? Like, kalau normal tour, tak ada lah kendirinya.
Virtual tour cannot replace status that you. Been to Paris, cannot.
Betul. Saya.
Yeah, you been to Danau Toba, virtual. Yeah. You have to be there by yourself.
Saya.
Yeah. Seeing sunrise in the morning, there's a lake behind the mountains, the hills. See it on the screen is different. Different line. Sensor. Yeah. Beda sekali. Lain sekali.
Tak dapat feel itunya.
So it's only a drive reduction. I like the words like this. Be a traveler, not a tourist. If you want to only take photos in Paris, in Eiffel Towers, you don't need traveling. You need a Photoshop. You can take a picture.
I want to see.
I like to travel.
Eiffel Tower.
Yeah.
The pictures behind me like this one. The background.
Yeah.
You need a green.
Green screen. Green
screen. And a Photoshop.
Yes.
You can be anywhere in the world.
Yeah.
But you cannot replace the real tour, real experience.
Yang right? Kata ya Bapak, walau seberapa canggih pun virtual tour ini ya, kami tetap mahu merasa sendiri orang kata tempat itu, kan? Macam Bapak bilang tadi. Kalau di virtual tournya ya, kami hanya bisa lihat Bapak makan baksonya, tapi kami enggak bisa merasa.
So, virtual tour, actually it's a combination of broadcasting, either information technology, and tourism. traveling gitu ya, tour and travel.
Jadi ya Bapak Bob, pada waktu pandemi ini ya, of course virtual tour itu ada growing interest lah, just because we want to feel kita punya anxiety ni ya sekarang kerana lockdown ya Pak. Jadi kalau misalnya kita itu back to normal ya nanti bila kita bisa travel lagi, pada pendapat Bapak ya, itu virtual tour itu atau skills-nya yang sekarang ini kita ajar kepada tour guide dan sebagainya, itu akan berguna lagi atau itu hanya untuk digunakan masa pandemi aja?
Walaupun pandemi sudah berakhir, ya, akan kembali. Virtual tour akan kembali ke fungsi awalnya. Well, virtual tour actually want to go to the places that we cannot go. Yeah, for example, I have a virtual tour to like travel inside the White House, Washington DC. All the places that, gitu ya, it's very difficult. Yeah, jadi kembali itu ke situ. Kedua, functionsnya buat meningkatkan pengetahuan, gain knowledge for training. Yeah, for a tour, new tourist guide, new tour leader, new destinations, kembali seperti itu. If I can pay to visit the original, the actual places, kenapa saya harus go virtual?
Benar, Bapak. Benar.
Seperti itu kan? Yeah. Jadi kembali seperti itu. I don't think that the virtual tour is going to be tumbuh nanti setelah ini. Tapi as a knowledge, as a skill, tetap akan develop, tetap, ya. Karena if you want to visit to Islandia or other countries, who can beat National Geographic or Discovery Channel?
Betul.
They give you detail, but not experience, real experience.
Yes. Yeah.
Itu aerial broadcast that been modified into, ya. Yeah, ya, in tour and travel business.
So yeah. Bapak kan even bila kita when we travel, physical travel, we will include the social interaction between one another, but we cannot find that in virtual tour. Virtual tour is like social interaction, because in normal physical guide people can socialize with one another. We can show body language and we can make eye contact with the with the guide and with one another,
and even make friends. We can actually make friends. Tapi kalau di virtual tour ni kadang-kadang ada yang guna Zoom itu, kita ada chat box kan. Kita oh hello, salam siang, oh nuhun gini-gini gitu. Tapi friendship-nya tak berkekalan ya, Pak.
Sampai situ aja ya, Madam.
So, the quality of communication in chat room, you cannot beat the real one. No, you cannot beat that. And sometimes terkadang di chat room is gaduh. Jadi itulah bedanya virtual tour dengan tour yang actual gitu.
Oke.
Jadi kan Bapak-bapak sebentar tadi di awal tadi Bapak-bapak ada sebut beberapa platform untuk conduct virtual tour, right? So basically in order to make a virtual tour tu berjaya, both participant dengan host kena very tech savvy, which is not everyone is. Kena ada current updated computer, laptop, phone, sebab kena ada 360 darjah degree view or panoramic picture. So the both host and participant dapat see different dimension, so it seems real and also futuristic to people. So basically bagi Bapak-bapak, which do you think the best platform to conduct or to experience virtual tour?
Until now, if it's recorded, paling bagus adalah memang YouTube.
YouTube.
But YouTube. But it's not live. Gitu ya. Usually the virtual tour, the professional one, they will lock. Yeah, they will lock the YouTube. is only like a private or limited, not open for public. So you have to pay first, then they will give you the link.
Yeah,
that's the professional way. It's quite expensive, yeah, karena production cost-nya, the camera, the 360 degrees, 8K now, not 4K, 8K now, gitu ya. The camera is very expensive, yeah, it can be about $10,000.
Yeah.
Yeah, karena it's, gitu. YouTube Live is okay.
So, Bapak, based on my experience, the one virtual tour that I joined was free.
Mm-hmm.
Both of the virtual tour that I joined was in Pulau Penyengat and in Zoo Melaka, Malaysia, Pulau Penyengat in Indonesia. So, as you mentioned before, all the courses might be, all the technology and the devices is quite high. So, what exactly are we charging in virtual tour, Bapak-Bapak?
Anda virtual tour yang saya lihat di ini kurang lebih sekitar $50. But the professional, very segmented.
Yeah.
Tapi ada sekarang yang namanya pay as you wish.
Yes.
Rekan-rekan, yang namanya pay as you wish, there is no guarantee it's a professional or not.
How we differentiate the professional and the unprofessional one?
From the production cost. If you have the skill, but not the proper equipment. Remember, the professional is you have to earn income. So production cost and the selling the package, the product should be bisa saling mengisi. Production cost sekian, gitu ya, dia harus kembali. It's impossible if the production cost is about 100, misalnya $100,000, and you say pay as you wish, cannot. Gitu.
Tapi Bapak, kalau lah dia suruh they put the higher charges in the virtual tour, do you think it can attract people to and to join their virtual tour? Because you know we cannot feel the five senses that we want to experience in the normal physical guide, but they still are charged in higher price.
It depends. You make a virtual tour. What is the purpose of doing a virtual tour? Apakah Anda only ingin apa mau hanya menyampaikan informasi? Tapi if it's scientifically gitu ya dipertanggungjawabkan gitu ya, sama seperti ada rekan saya itu can earn dalam rupiah gitu ya bisa mungkin 20-30 juta, tapi scientifically all the informations, the quality, he must go to the mountain gitu ya, bring a camera, recording, upload it, give information and everything well prepared professionally. Value-nya, harganya pasti, price-nya pasti lebih mahal karena production cost. I don't want to generate all the things, tapi usually the one who say pay as you wish gitu ya, you must be careful. Can be taken from YouTube, not productions by himself.
Maksudnya copyright ya,
Bapak?
Copyright. Yeah. Copyright. It's a problem about copyright. I can take all the pictures from Google. Yeah. Jadi, the quality of the product, the originality, yeah, the authenticity of the qualities of the quality of the product. So, if you want to do it professionally, all the production costs should be professional. And although sekarang ini pandemic begitu, they're still doing a productions. Ya? Inilah waktunya mereka. After the pandemic, they will still doing the productions.
Okay, Bapak, macam Bapak cakap tadi, in handling virtual tour, we know that tour guide need a high quality devices. But it's quite pricey. But it is a necessary item, right? to have in conducting virtual tour. So, besides, this tour guide also didn't get any incentive from the authority to encourage them in make this transition, right? So how we can make the technology more affordable in this context?
Okay, guys, now it's the time of surviving. Okay, as a tourist guide, as the like a classical tourist guide, I just know how to give informations, describe, do a persuasive explanations about the object. Yeah, But now I have to learn about technology. So I have to learn about information technology, how to use it, the quality of the camera. For broadcasting, broadcasting, you have to know angle, you have to know lighting, yeah. You cannot take a pictures against matahari, sun. Yeah. Technically, he must learn. That's why this is a combination between tourism, broadcasting, and information technology. So you have to gather all that information. When you are running a video live, I have a friend who's doing a live with his camera. Oh, I've been doing an avatar. There's a training, from people from around Indonesia, the Polisi Republik Indonesia. I'm the trainer. I do as an avatar. Zoom. They command me.
Wow.
Straight. Doing the training. So I cannot move without their command.
Ooh.
That's the live training. It's not a virtual tour, but almost look alike. So they command me to go this way, okay, do this, buy a ticket and everything. Together. So must be a very good bandwidth, the camera and everything. Jadi rekan-rekan, it's not only a virtual tour, but if you're doing a live virtual tour, that's the most ideal, paling ideal, paling almost, and the professional doing the professional one doing that.
Jadi Bob, I understand that you also teach how to handle virtual tours your students. So I think one of the biggest challenges lah when I join some of the virtual tours, of the biggest challenges I find is to actually keep the momentum and keep the engagement going, especially kalau we're talking about virtual tour yang berbayar, So if I had paid for something, I'm of course I want to make sure that I pay. I mean, I enjoy the money that I paid, right?
Yeah.
So there should be certain level of engagement ability for the virtual tour to remain. My question ya Pak, lebih kepada engagement itu. Jadi apa yang kita harus tekankan sebagai host virtual tour itu supaya engagement itu berterusan?
Yang pertama pasti yang namanya, this is technical for a tourist guide, communications-nya. Tidak boleh one way.
Yes.
You have to give them waktu to enjoy dan chatting istilahnya. Dan kalau actual real world is there any questions? That skill live dalam arti actual side dengan virtual is very limited
right. Kadang-kadang kalau misalnya bapak jalan, when you go and then me as participant, no, stop there. I want to see this. Kalau di in real life, mungkin saya ditinggalkan di belakang, benar.
Jadi yang the professional one, gila, rekan-rekan, kontrolnya usually kalau saya bilang virtual tour itu the operator. But the new technology in virtual tour, control seeing movement-nya bisa di tamu, audience-nya. Ada tools gitu, misalnya lagi, ladies and gentlemen, we are in Big Ben in London right now. This is the tower, there's a clock, Big Ben. You control the view, the picture, the view. You can control to see up and control the left and right.
Right.
Selama ini kita taunya virtual tour only satu view saja. Tapi in the professional one yang the current one they have a navigation tools full untuk lihat. That's a 360 degrees camera.
Jadi, itu kita akan lihat sebentar nanti Pak.
Puan Aswin bisa lihat ke kanan, saya bisa ke kiri. Ya, seperti itu ya. Jadi
kita bisa lihat Bapak yang Bapak mention tadi itu betul-betulnya ada yang beda-beda ya, ada yang 360. Jadi kalau Bapak bisa kongsikan the participant mau lihat.
Ya,
betul. Okay. Mana itu video?
Boleh kita share ya, Pak?
Boleh kita share ya, Pak.
Contoh-contohnya,
saya
Pak.
Saya bagi contoh ya, beberapa ya, yang dibuat oleh broadcaster sama yang real professional ya.
Okay. Boleh.
Izin saya untuk share ya.
Oke.
Okay. Hi, and welcome to London. My name is Peter, and I'm going to show you around to all the great hotspots of this city, like the Big Ben behind me, the Westminster Abbey on the right of you, and many more. So, come follow me.
Wow, 360.
The tower in front of you is called the Big Ben, wow. One of the most striking and well-known tower clocks in the world. In fact, the Big Ben is not the clock itself. It is actually the name of the big bell inside the tower, and its official name is the Great Bell. It was built in 1859 and is one of the most prominent symbols in the United Kingdom. Another great symbol is this 1,000-year-old church, the Westminster Abbey. It has been used as a venue for many famous and royal weddings, like that of Prince William and Kate Middleton. It's also the final resting place for many great Brits, like Darwin, Newton, and Dickens. The entrance fee is 20 quid. Trafalgar Square is located in the city of Westminster. It is surrounded by musea and other cultural hotspots. It's also a very popular square for street musicians to perform.
One is 360, not
VR. Awesome music, guys. Reminds me of one of the great British bands who recorded their most iconic album in a studio somewhere here in the city.
So you might wonder why these people are taking pictures of an ordinary crossing, but this is not just a normal crossing. It's a crossing the Beatles used for their cover of Abbey Road. Oh. And the studio is right around here.
The best way to move around the city is by metro, or as the Londoners call it, the tube.
The next station is Hounslow West. Please mind the gap between the train and the platform.
If you want to treat yourself to something really special after a long day in the city, you might consider going here, to this venue. It's one of the most famous concert halls in the world. Jimi Hendrix, The Beatles, The Cure, they all played here. And tonight, Eric Clapton is playing, and I'm gonna get my ticket.
British Got Talent, the final, showing to the Queen the concert hall sini.
Wow. This is free.
Not free, invitation.
Oh.
Okay. Tadi gambar virtual itu downloaded ya?
Yes.
Not in YouTube ya? Okay. Karena itu downloaded, jadi 360, but actually itu technically gitu, if you doing it in YouTube, there is a tools di kiri atas.
Wow.
Yeah, you can look to the left and to the right. So different audience, yeah, I can be look to the left, you can think ke kanan. Control by the audience, not from the camera of the producers, gitu. Now virtual tour yang kita mungkin pernah ikuti, based on my camera ataupun dari yang saya bawa, lihat segini gitu. Tapi seperti Puan Aswin bilang, saya mau lihat ke kiri, dia kasih.
Iya,
benar.
Kok ada, bisa?
Seperti itu. Ya, in an actual tour, everybody can look left and right.
Yeah,
up to them.
Right.
Seperti itu. Nah, that's professional. So the camera is, the equipment is very expensive.
I see.
Cannot be paid as you wish. Okay, ini ada satu lagi, gitu ya, yang Niagara Falls. Karena yang lain is already common. Oh, Niagara Falls is
Niagara Falls. Itu
menarik sekali. Coba yeah. Nisha.
Yes. Coba.
Okay. The different dengan yang di Niagara Falls, there is no narration at all. So I'll do the guiding.
Based I see.
On the video. So with this kind of pictures, we only purchase or use the video. I'll do the guiding. So the apa tuh the guiding technique, but you can put like a trivia in these pictures. For example, right now we are in the American Falls of the Niagara Falls in United States of America.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah, we are in the United States side, and this is the American Falls. Yeah.
Yeah, we can see.
The wide is about 300 meters. Yeah. Across is the Canadian side of the Niagara Falls.
Right.
You can have a dinner or lunch buffet in the tower. And 60 degrees circling restaurant. Yeah.
Cantik banget. That's the Canadian. Rindu sekali mau ke sana nih.
So there is no narration at all. So I'll do the narrations. This is a virtual tour. Other professionals.
This is
professional. Yeah.
Hey, Kimmy.
Yeah.
Wow, pengen ke sana ya.
This is my favorite.
Life before
place
COVID.
Bagus banget okay. Ya gambarnya, Pak.
Almost 10 times.
Very clear yeah. Ya gambarnya.
Yeah.
Wow.
So this is some Niagara Falls. So actually Niagara Falls is about a kilometer. It's 700 meters. The Horseshoe Fall, the famous one, is in the Canadian side.
Mm.
The American side is 300 meters. So you don't have any visa for Canada, you can visit the United States.
Yeah.
Okay.
Wow.
Tadi ada dua sampel, the professional one. Kalau misalnya ada yang sebelum ini mungkin yang berbeda. Itu contoh yang lain.
Boleh.
Ya, yeah. Itu ada juga sampel-sampelnya.
Taman Marga
Satwa Ragunan.
Iya.
Kita sekarang nih di Taman Marga Satwa Ragunan ya, Rakan-rakan.
Selamat datang ya, Rakan-rakan.
Ya. Guide ya, Bapak.
Halo sahabat Ragunan.
Saya percaya ini yang buat orang broadcast. Karena apa? Ini drone.
Sudah lama ya Taman Marga Satwa Ragunan ditutup untuk umum.
Tidak mungkin kita sebagai wisatawan melihat dari sisi. Nah,
benar-benar.
Ya, tidak mungkin ya.
Atas ya Bapak.
Tidak mungkin.
Ini benar drone nih.
Kita jalan-jalan di Taman Marga
Satwa. Ini drone.
Melalui video ini.
Ini drone. Drone pasti orang-orang broadcast biasanya.
Di Taman Marga Satwa Ragunan terdapat banyak fasilitas penunjang ya, bagi para pengunjung.
Ya.
Di antaranya ada Taman Satwa Anak dan Pusat Primata Smutzer.
Ini juga lagi tutup.
Taman Satwa mau lihat hewannya.
Bagi pengunjung
ya. Anak. Aku juga.
Di mana anak-anak dapat bermain ada di dalamnya.
Mana Tiger?
Bermain dengan
my friend.
Main area ya, mana itu teman si Askin?
Oh, ini bukan ya? Ini bukan.
Ah, ini kamu. Kamu ini. Chicken. Ini kamu.
Sedangkan, takut. Sahabat Ragunan bisa melihat tingkah laku berbagai jenis primata. Mulai dari primata asli Indonesia seperti orang utan, siamang, owa,
saya dan utuh, tidak boleh masuk ke Ragunan ataupun ke taman safari.
Seperti gorila.
Kalau saya masuk tidak boleh keluar. DC
dengan area
beruang
luas
ataupun elephant stay inside. Once you get in, you cannot get out.
yang bertujuan agar satu yang okay. tinggal di dalamnya.
Gitu.
Ini contoh yang dibuat oleh orang-orang broadcaster mempergunakan
Taman
Drone.
Taman Marga Satwa Ragunan sendiri memiliki beberapa pintu
video
masuk,
Google
pintu
Google
utara,
dan juga
pintu barat, dan juga pintu
pictures
timur.
Biasa. Itu yang satu
jika
lagi.
Sahabat Ragunan
yang pertama. Jadi kita bisa lihat which one is the professional one, ya. Terus kemudian control fully by the operator, ada yang share antara professional doing the guide, ya, actual place but the navigations di oleh para wisatawannya. Ada juga yang kamera saja yang bergerak, sound zero narrations. Saya sebagai tourist guide-nya harus gini. Jadi many types of virtual tour. Ya. Beda-beda dan quality dan production cost-nya different masing-masing.
Saya percaya partisipan juga first time ya lihat tahu yang virtual tour juga ada beda-beda ya, Pak. Macam professional punya and the one that use the drone. So I think this is the new knowledge for us.
Yeah. Jadi bukan hanya satu tipe atau one type of virtual tour. It's different. Yeah. So dari apa yang disajikan, I know this is a broadcaster productions.
Wow.
Ini dari orang-orang yang TV, television, atau apa. Ya, karena saya pendidikan ini mass communications juga kan. Mm-hmm. Gitu. Oh, ini didesain productions-nya oleh orang-orang dengan media background.
Mm.
Benar.
Ini ya, the professional one design basically it's a tourist guide and also a professional in equipment ya, yeah, technology. Ah. Itu sudah mix semuanya.
Right.
Seperti itu. Jadi you can identify oh ini virtual tour. Ya, ini yang professional, ini yang amatir lah.
Jadi kalau buat waktu ini ya, Pak, are the existing tour guide being a train for virtual tour di sana?
Yes.
Itu satu option atau kemestian di sana?
Ya. Yeah. Tourist guide-nya harus tahu how to operate. Begitu. Gitu. Saya baru dapat tugas buat kementerian untuk buat like a presentation seperti itu. Wow. Ya, dengan background-nya saya menjelaskan di sini objeknya di apa ini objeknya ini saya harus do presentation sini. Nah nanti mereka yang tempelkan itu the moving pictures, the video dengan apa yang saya sampaikan. Timingnya ada timingnya. 15 second you have to explain this apa segala macam. Just like doing a show. Ya. Yeah? Just like doing like a entertainment, ya. Yeah? Itu that skill hanya di broadcast bukan di tourism because as a tourist guide one object I can explain it for 5 minutes, I can explain for 1 hour.
Wow.
Skill saya di situ.
Yeah.
Tapi not about angle of camera, voice.
I see. Yeah.
Bandwidth, no nothing.
Right.
So, if you want to do a virtual tour, you have to have a knowledge technically in tourism, or tour and travel, broadcast, and information technology.
That's a must. Okay, Bapak. So, what is the level of digital exposure among the tourist guide in Indonesia? As we know that, Indonesia has many more virtual tour as compared to in Malaysia.
Okay. Biasanya yang bagus-bagus, they have a background in information technology. Or hobby. Yeah, I know that the guide is doing a virtual tour have a technical background. He's an engineer.
Wow.
Yeah.
Also an engineer. Gitu.
Engineer.
Jadi, waktu mengolah, it's easy for them. Yeah. the narration as a tourist guide, they can learn it technically.
Jadi kita fokus kontennya aja.
Konten. How to build narrations.
Yeah.
Terus do timing. Nah, remember how long the for a virtual tour?
How long it should be, Pak? How long it should be supaya engagement itu bagus?
Betul, Pak. Berapa lama itu?
Maximum, gitu ya. Same like in the class.
Two hours
maximum.
2 hours.
After 1.5 hour, concentration is going to be down.
Yes.
Benar-benar,
Pak. Tapi kalau kelas saya, Pak, 15 menit hilang terus.
In a class maximum 1.5 hours.
Yeah.
That's a maximum concentrations. After 1.5 hours, the
good. Yeah.
If you are teaching in the class, you will know.
Bunyinya
that.
Juga ada, Pak. Bunyinya juga.
Jadi bapak-bapak, saya sudah sediakan video di Museum Bank. Saya share screen-nya.
Silakan di.
Hai kids, apa kabar hari pertama puasa ini? Untuk menemani kamu di hari pertama puasa ini, Great Kids akan ajak kamu jalan-jalan di Museum Bank Indonesia. Kali ini ada yang unik nih. Kamu bisa jalan-jalan di Museum Indonesia secara virtual loh. Sebelum kamu coba sendiri, yuk Great Kids akan menunjukkan apa saja yang bisa kamu lihat di dalam museum. Pertama, kita akan mulai masuk. Ikutin tanda panahnya ya. Nah, sekarang kita udah ada di lobi Museum Bank Indonesia. Kita bisa melihat berbagai sudut ruangan yang ada di Museum Bank Indonesia ini. Sebelum kita lanjut menjelajah museumnya, jangan lupa klik tombol subscribe dan tombol loncengnya ya.
Boleh.
Pada 1828, ruangan ini digunakan sebagai ruangan rapat direksi. Lalu sempat mengalami renovasi tahap kedua pada 1922. Ruangan ini dikenal sebagai ruangan hijau karena memang dekorasinya yang penuh dengan warna hijau. Selain disebut green room, ruangan ini juga sering disebut sebagai ruang inspirasi. Saat itu, warna hijau ini dianggap dapat membuat mereka yang rapat di tempat ini bisa mengambil keputusan dengan tenang karena aura positif dari suasana ruangan ini. Tapi akhirnya fungsi ruangan ini berubah menjadi ruang kerja administrasi pusat. Meeting room. Sama seperti namanya kids, ruangan ini adalah ruangan meeting untuk mereka memutuskan sesuatu tentang Bank Indonesia dan uang di Indonesia pada masa itu. History area. Ruangan ini ternyata baru beberapa tahun ini diresmikan, tepatnya pada November 2018. Ruangan ini dibuat untuk mengajak kita, generasi milenial, untuk lebih tertarik datang ke museum. Kamu bisa melihat berbagai sejarah tentang perjalanan uang dan Bank Indonesia yang ditampilkan dengan tampilan modern yang menarik. Kamu bisa melihat berbagai patung Praga.
She's a narrator.
Tapi bagus juga ya, Pak.
She's a narrator.
Yang menunjukkan apa yang terjadi pada masa itu. Selain itu, di sini juga ada disediakan layar interaktif yang akan menunjukkan berbagai informasi tentang sejarah. Teater. Seperti namanya, tempat ini untuk kamu menonton. Kamu bisa melihat tentang sejarah Bank Indonesia, bagaimana kebijakan Bank Indonesia dari dulu sampai sekarang. Dan yang pastinya, sejarah uang kids. Film ini hanya akan diputar jam 10 dan 1 siang.
Bagus.
Periodical room. Ruangan ini dibagi menjadi beberapa bagian. Setiap bagian menceritakan perjalanan Bank Indonesia. Setiap periode bagaimana perjalanan Bank Indonesia mulai diterima masyarakat dan dunia, hingga sempat...
Itu kalau tour guide lain lagi ya, Pak?
Different.
Gimana kita boleh bisa
tahu? The name is virtual tour, gitu ya?
Yeah.
So, kalau tour guide, harusnya, now we are in. Gitu. Kalimatnya is very different. Gitu ya. Tapi kalau voice over seperti tadi, gitu ya, ruang green screen. So
ini,
it's
ruang
only
green.
Delivering information. That's the...
Oh, keren banget. Ya. Mau lagi.
Ini okay, baru. So... Saya kasih sampelnya cuma 4 aja, tapi different type, tapi nanti bisa classifications. Oh, this is the professional, this is the amateur, this is made by a broadcaster, this is made by tourism people. So
jadi
tourism
bahwa
people
ini,
must be different, the virtual tour.
Jadi buat waktu ini Bapak Bob ada conduct any virtual tour sendiri?
Saya lebih concentration lagi di mengajar dan belajar dulu. Okay. Ini di awal-awal saya buat dan ini ada rekan yang minta untuk bantu untuk Sumba.
Sumba.
Sumba. One small island ya.
Yeah.
Di Labuan Bajo di sana untuk virtual tour. Yeah. Tapi typical kecepatannya harus tetap recording atau pre-recorded dibuat di jadi productionsnya quality-nya harus broadcasting. Tapi narrationsnya harus tourist guide. Itu idealnya. You have to mesh it gitu. Jadi nggak bisa oh this is a virtual tour, it's a broadcasting. You can see it better in the National Geographic or Discovery Channel. Right. So it's different. It's different. Mm.
Ya Bapak, maknanya Bapak lepas daripada talk kita ini, kawan-kawan kita, rakan-rakan kita yang lain sudah boleh membezakan ya Bapak, mana satu yang broadcast, mana satu engineer,
master, mana satu amateur and professional.
Yes. Yeah. So banyak-banyak sekali ya Bapak info yang dapat kita dapat daripada Bapak Bob ini. So kan Lisa kan?
Betul tu, banyak sekali ya. Like yeah. Kita range-range dia tu semua kan?
Mm. Ya saya harus berhenti ya buat virtual tour karena virtual tour saya enggak bagus sekali.
Jadi boleh lagi lah madam, boleh lagi.
Boleh. Ya. Aku mau tukar profession sudah nih. Mau lagi.
Nah, YouTuber madam,
boleh pergi ke Melaka
ni. Nah, kita coba ya, fighting, fighting.
Yeah. Yeah, fighting.
and I think our participant also have some question to ask to Bapak Bob. And
ramai ni yang tanya ni.
Yes.
Yeah.
Ramai ni mau tanya ni Pak.
Okay, saya nak tanya berkenaan dengan virtual tour. So kalau contohnya program yang ada buat virtual tour dekat Indonesia, contohnya, so macam mana dengan registration untuk open international, maksudnya macam boleh open to Malaysian punya orang untuk join the virtual tour, and then how about the language yang dia akan guna ataupun hanya untuk orang Indonesia sahaja join, tak boleh international?
Good question tau Pak. Itu soalan tu kan saya tambah ya. Bagaimana payment mode-nya itu Pak?
Payment mode ya.
Iya, kalau mau join. Iya.
Pertanyaannya bagus sekali. Sama seperti sementara ini virtual tour gitu ya. Itu disajikan cuman biasanya satu bahasa saja pasti. Kalau ini ya, enggak bisa didubbing gitu ya.
Iya. Gitu,
Korean pada saat yang bersama tidak bisa. Tapi so it's English in English or in Indonesian seperti itu. Kalau marketnya untuk other than Indonesians, ya pasti dia bilang in English. Itu udah pasti professional. Like a tour package. Right. It's a tour package. So you have to design it. So tour leader atau tourist guide-nya will English speaking tourist guide. Seperti itu. They have to announce it. Then they, in the package, they sell it. How they promote? Usually. Not in the, it's a, from social media usually, yeah, from Instagram, Facebook group, gitu ya, seperti itu, sama seperti tadi kan, subscribe, mungkin free tapi subscribe by click, gitu kan, they can monetize. Tapi from my experience yang namanya virtual tour terlalu sedikit untuk dapat monetize dari klik di YouTube. Ya, seperti itu. So, Anda tahu bahwa paket itu dalam bahasa Inggris, sometimes they have a chat, you can chat, is it delivered in English or bahasa Indonesia? So, ada komunikasi dengan produsernya dulu, with the virtual tour operator-nya. Seperti itu. Ya, nah, itu seperti itu. Sementara ini baru sampai productions saja. Untuk marketingnya saya rasa masih from personal social media. Seperti itu Hanisa. Ya, jadi kalaupun nggak tahu di luar pakai bahasa Indonesia atau English, Anda bisa chat. Itu enaknya kalau baru di awal ya dimulai seperti itu. Ya, Jadi Anda waktu menjual produknya harus kasih tahu bahwa tour ini ya will be gitu ya conducted in English
right.
atau Indonesian. Seperti itu. Sementara ini para yang produksi Indonesia buat orang Indonesia dulu.
Yeah.
Not in English.
Yeah, oke. Okay. Terima kasih.
Terima kasih.
Terima kasih Anissa.
Terima kasih Anissa. Okay. So, anyone else lagi?
Hello, saya ada soalan.
Oh, yes. Ada.
Yes, silakan.
Okay. Hi, Mr. Bob, Monica.
Hi, Anna.
Organizing committee and friends.
Hi.
Okay, Mr. Bob, I have a question. In next decade, 10 years, do you see that virtual tour can be a booming business?
What?
Yes.
Yeah.
So what's your opinion?
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Very good question. Okay, jadi actual experience you cannot replace it virtually. Yeah, you cannot replace actual experience. Gitu ya. Although now Google try to Google Sense ya, everywhere about Google Sense.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So yeah, tapi very limited. Yeah. Harus very advanced technology, because the sensor ya pada saat Anda misalnya buat culinary ya mau to taste something nasi lemak you have to taste it with your tongue,
betul itu,
not with your eyes, seperti itu ya,
benar Bapak.
So seperti itu ya, Musang King you have to taste it, begitu ya. So seperti itu yang you cannot sense it with your eyes only, gitu ya, seperti itu. So booming, I don't think so. Yeah. Yeah. So for preparations, I believe that virtual tour can be like tools, yeah. So you can prepare and effectively enjoy your actual experience, and but you cannot actually replace it with the actual one. Seperti itu, Adam.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Yeah.
All right. Thank you, Adam.
Sama-sama, Adam.
All right. Anyone else?
Anyone has question?
I have a question. Like, you say just now, like, for virtual tour experience, if you want to experience it virtually, we have to pay, right? But how to compete with the all the free videos that was uploaded on YouTube or that was shared on TikTok or like other platforms? How to compete with all that present it for free? For yeah, you know what I mean?
That's a very good question. So if you want to compete, the quality of the product first, yeah. Other videos in the social media you upload it in YouTube. How deep is the information they give? Yeah. They're not like this. In social media, it's not about sharing, but it's more like kalau kita bilang existing. I've been there. Gitu. It's a narcissism. You want to show yourself that you've been, but the quality of information usually, how tall is the Eiffel Tower? Why they built the Eiffel Tower? You cannot interpret the tourist object. Tourist guide, yeah. The role of tourist guide is to interpret the object. YouTubers usually tell everyone about the objects if they are in the video. Yeah, I've been here, gitu ya. Just like that, but not interpreting the objects. yeah. Hey, I've been in Paris. This is Eiffel Tower. So beautiful. Just like that. You can see it in the social media.
Okay?
But tourist guide have to explain 5W, 1H, yeah. Where, what, who, where, when, you know. You have to explain to interpret the tourism. Yeah, that's the role, yeah, and function of a tourist guide. That's why virtual tour, the quality is about the narrations of the story about the object, yeah, and how to engage with it. Yeah, social, usually YouTube social media is only one way. You can interact only comment, yes, but not engagement, not in the first, not like in the virtual tour. That's different between social media and virtual tour. Yeah, seperti itu, Liana. Cukup jelas ya?
Jelas, jelas. Terima kasih.
Terima kasih sama-sama, Liana.
Terima kasih, Liana.
Oke, ada siapa lagi nak tanya?
Can I ask?
Yeah. Silakan.
Oke, okay, Amira from out
media. Punya.
Yes, Amira.
Saya enggak marah. Ya.
Tidak.
Okay, Bapak-bapak, as you mentioned before that YouTube is like the best platform to conduct virtual tour, right? But some other countries or organization, they also provide a really great virtual tour. For example, like NASA, they has released this one unique program, especially for kids, where they can experience the planet, such as the sun, the moon, and the Mars. And just like you said before, like we can even visit a volcano virtually. So I mean, like, how amazing all of this technology can be today. Mm-hmm. So, but the thing is, all of this requires certain technology such as VR spec or maybe high quality earphones and all that to experience a better virtual tour. So, Bapak-bapak, how much can our virtual tour experience can be improved by having this kind of technology?
So, like I said before, you have to work or to study to enhance yourself. Mm-hmm. Oh, sorry, I'm talking from tourist guide side. Yeah.
Okay. Sure.
So, if I want to go, the NASA is very good. Yeah, they have the money, they have the technology, they have the people. Gitu, yeah. So. It's not the real tour actually. It's a virtual. Gitu ya. No one go beyond Mars. Gitu ya. Yeah. It's like that. Like this. For a virtual tour, actually, it's for scientific reason. Yeah. Yeah. So they can like. It's like a science fiction movie. Mm-hmm. Yeah. No one been to Mars, Saturn. Gitu ya. Only from pictures. But with technology, you can put it in the 3D, 4D, or something like that.
Right.
Yeah. Do a simulations.
Right.
Even that's a virtual tour. It's not a virtual tour, but from National Geographic or Discovery Channel, you can enter the blood vessels.
Yes.
Wow.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
I want to be there.
Gitu ya.
I
want to be there. And there's a movie, gitu ya, kalau misalnya. Now with the technology and the money and everything, so you can design. That's a virtual. They call it virtual reality. It's not a virtual tour actually.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because in tour you have to be have a good narrations, gitu ya, interactions. And,
mungkin juga kita bisa buat
NASA.
Virtual horror ya, Pak. Yeah. Virtual horror.
I've been to NASA.
Oh, Medel.
Been to NASA and to Houston.
Yeah.
Gitu. I've been to NASA and Houston, gitu ya. They have the
technology ya, Pak.
The money, the technology. Yeah. I entered the room, the virtual one. It's actually we enter the room, the theater, and we visit the planet. Like that. But from the theater they move it into the TV or the virtual tour. Right now I think mereka pindahkan itu dari teaternya mereka ke TV atau apa. But the production cost. Yeah.
Itu kan Pak, kadang-kadang kita ada tour yang horror tour kan. Itu hantu. Kita pergi ke rumah-rumah yang horror-horror kan.
Okay.
Itu banyak juga di US, US. Di Amerika banyak
yang
sekali.
Yang paling ini di London, Bu.
Oh.
Di London dan di Sydney ada visiting-nya. Terus di York City is very famous for the haunted tour-nya.
Oh. Jadi kalau seperti start itu haunted tour-nya itu saya nggak mau pergi yang real punya. So we join the virtual, itu hantunya keluar nggak?
Harus lihat cermin dulu. Harus lihat cermin dulu. Lihat hantu yang ini nggak takut melihat cermin dari itu.
Tengok diri sini lagi takut ya Bapak Bo.
Oh, panggil saya hantu ya?
Tak ada ingat nama dia.
Dia orang lain dia ni. Orang lain.
Jadi gitu ya Amira ya. Jadi it's not they just cuman transform aja dari satu sajian broadcasting with scientific virtual gitu ya. Dan dia ganti jadi virtual tour, gitu ya. Actually it's a presentation, it's a broadcasting one. Tapi they move it. When they do interactions, that's a tour. Engagement tadi yang Puan Aswin bilang. Ya, in Disneyland, Universal Studio, all that is from the movie. But they do an engagement. Yeah, they like acting. Yeah, so in the virtual tour, you have to do acting too.
Benar, Bapak. Yeah,
just like in the real, the actual places, not only in virtual. So you have to do like you are in the actual place. That will help the engagement between you and the tourist.
Make it more interesting.
Yeah.
Jadi kalau hantu-hantu juga harus diengagekan ya Pak.
Kalau bila perlu, tapi nanti proses eksorsismenya susah nanti itu.
Dirasuk semua.
Jadi kalau misalnya ke zoo ya Pak, kalau haiwan-haiwannya itu kita harus dia tuh harus aktif juga. Kalau dia tidur terus tuh, jadi bosan juga kan. Jadi harimau seperti Ashikin juga harus dibangunkan ya Pak.
Iya. Gerak gini-gini.
Betul. Rekan-rekan, ada satu hal yang jadi in virtual tour there's a creativity. I have a friend who doing like this in virtual tournya. So if it's culinary, gitu ya, in the package, the tour package, he send all the foods to the people who bought the tour culinary tour.
I want really? To join.
Mau. Tapi kalau di Malaysia nggak sampai lah baksonya ya Pak.
Basi.
Jadi kembali tadi, makanan sudah dikirim pada waktu yang ditentukan, semua buka, dan semua merasakan sama-sama sama dia.
Bagus ya.
Jadi cara makannya, cara ini, it's about creativity, virtual tour. Ya, dia buat package-nya, ya jadi it's include delivering food-nya, harga food-nya, itu di quote, benar-benar di quotations. Bahkan, ada beberapa misalnya yang ini is like a, buah tangan ya, oleh-oleh gitu. Mm. Gitu. Dari Bandung itu dia doing a virtual tour tapi package oleh-oleh ataupun buah tangan dari Bandung ini sudah dikirim dulu.
Oh. Dikirim dulu sebelum tournya, Pak.
Dikirim dulu. Jadi kan dia dia sudah bayar paket tournya. That's include the package and the delivery dari oleh-olehnya.
Oh. Ini ada soalan nih. Ada soalan lagi nih, Pak.
Iman sabar ya.
Dari Iman.
Ya,
mana?
Iman.
Silakan.
Halo, hai.
Hai.
Halo Iman.
Mana Iman?
Hai Iman.
Hai Iman.
Hai semua. So I have a question, like this is more on a recorded version lah, bukan yang live virtual tour. Like to produce a very good footage, mesti like kita macam kena editing tu banyak kan. But how long does it takes to make a complete virtual tour with the narration and so on? Macam lama tak untuk hasilkan sesuatu virtual tour tu for one place? It's for one place.
Wow. Okay. Ya production ya Pak. Jadi kalau kita mau bikin film ya, berapa lama Pak bikin filmnya?
Yeah. It depends how skillful you are, gitu ya, and how in quality-nya. Tapi like pakai patokan film drama Korea saja lah. Weekly.
Bapak drama Koreanya lama Bapak.
Iman. Yeah. Tergantung juga drama Korea bagaimana episode kan kerja sama.
Benar. Yeah. So, I have a friend who doing this. Monday, you taking a break. Okay.
Okay.
Tuesday, meeting with the, gitu. Wednesday, preparations buat script, ya semua, gitu ya. Thursday, shooting. Yeah. Friday, editing, ya. Yeah. Terus kemudian Saturday preparations, Sunday sudah disiarkan. Saturday disiarkan. Seperti itu. It's a weekly regular.
Tapi productionnya sama aja atau lain-lain?
Different destinations. So, but yeah, my friend dia tour leader, dia tour leader tourist guide. Dia hanya jadi presenternya, jadi tourist guide, tour leader-nya. Yeah. Gitu. But the production is professional. And it's costly. There's a production cost.
Ramai ke?
Production cost.
Apa?
Ramai ke production team yang tolong editkan gitu. The whole.
Oh, pasti ramai ya, Pak.
My friend have a team 4 people.
Iman dia ada cita-cita Pak mau buat. Edit.
Boleh.
Ya dia ada cita-cita mau bikin company virtual tour.
Sesuatu virtual tour.
Gitu.
Iya.
Kalau based on broadcast, you can cut it in the 3 minutes, 4 minutes, then you link it up. But the live cannot. All the way, the camera and
it's very difficult. Itu nama company-nya sudah ada, Pak.
It's very difficult.
Nama company-nya.
Kongko Wisata. Kongko Wisata.
My company.
Ya. Apa ya, Pak? Kongko Wisata? Apa? Kongko Wisata. Kongko?
Nanti saya kasih link-nya, Bu, ke panitia.
Ah, boleh. Terima kasih.
Seperti itu.
Terima kasih, Ibu Sabaria. Terima kasih.
Good question.
Okay, Bapak Bob. Dekat chat ni kita ada soalan daripada Muhammad Taufik.
Nabila. Okay.
Ada lagi.
Iman. Semua mau jadi moderator, Pak. Semua. Masuk semua.
Hai Iman. Selamat siang Pak, selamat siang Madam, selamat siang organizer. So soalan saya Pak, apa tu in the future? Kalau pandemik kita mulai sembuh atau mulai baik, adakah kita masih menggunakan virtual tour ni? Sebab since turis pun dah boleh keluar kan, so adakah masih lagi legit untuk guna visual? Salah saya.
Okay. Terima kasih. Very good questions. Apakah misalnya sebagai satu perusahaan, you want to compete selling virtual tour dengan actual tour-nya? Kira-kira mau jual yang mana?
The real one.
Virtual tour-nya akan menjadi kayak gimmicks atau advertising atau teaser.
Marketing.
Orang supaya ikut. Yeah.
Marketing.
The marketing promotions. Mm-hmm. Kembali ke habitnya dia yang lama kalau pandemic sudah lewat. Jadi sebuat teaser, buat promotions, advertising gitu. Dan dia akan di-cut seperti itu. Sekarang begini, kalau semuanya sudah saya sampaikan di virtual tour, ngapain lagi Anda pergi? All the informations gitu ya, already give it to you before you depart. Just kenapa? Reduction drive-nya sudah berkurang. All the informations. Dia tidak akan ikut tour. Mereka akan traveling sendiri. Buy tiket, hotel, apa segala macam. You already given explanations buat saya sudah ini om. Ini tuh. Seperti itu. Dia jalan sendiri. Ya, seperti itu. Tidak akan di tour package lagi. Tergantung perusahaannya, mau rugi atau mau untung. Ya.
Ya mau sekali rugi gitu atau mau untung emang. Ya,
Pak.
Ya, pikirkan ya.
Seperti itu, Emma, ya.
Pikirkan ya.
Mau untung lah, Medan.
Tapi Pak, kalau yang virtual tournya ini ya, kalau sudah pandemik ini sudah berakhir, I still believe that there is still people that still afraid to travel, right? Because they still like macam kalau orang kata
uncertain lah ya.
Certain people still
unsure, tidak confident.
Tak confident nak pergi travel. Jadi virtual tour ini masih relevant. Saya rasa lah. Masih relevan ya Pak? Kalau ada ya, teman-teman pasti dari Indonesia yang mau tanya soalan, bisa.
Iya. Siapa yang dari Indonesia? Mari kita dengar.
Ada dari Indonesia.
Dari. Ya, siapa tuh? Siapa halo tuh?
Siapa tuh?
Mana dia?
Hai.
Eh, tuh Om Bob Rosli udah balik.
Iya, apa kabar? Dari mana?
Nih. Om Bob ini udah balik tuh.
Ini public relations-nya Indonesian Tour Leaders Association.
Oh, hello Ibu.
Hai.
Hai, Sis Rosli.
Hello. Di mana tuh? Di Jakarta atau di Bandung atau di mana-mana?
Saya di Jakarta.
Ah.
Guys, I want to promote you. Miss Rosni have a driver license. Tour coaches, big coaches.
Benar nih. Wow.
So, if a coach captain in Europe, kalau mereka tidak obey tour leader, she will drive. She will
Charlie's Angel gitu ya, kayak Ibu Rosli. I'm a survivor, I'm a believer, I'm a soccer. Ya.
Jadi bagus, jangan macam-macam ya, coach driver ya di Europe sama-sama.
Salam kenal Ibu, salam kenal.
Ya, salam juga kenal. Om Bob, I think someone here want to ask about Indonesia, but I don't know which one.
Ya, ada yang mau tanya?
Ada Iqbal.
Iqbal.
Iqbal, silakan Iqbal.
Selamat siang Pak Meda Azwin dan organizing team. Saya nak tanyalah soalan ni. Dia macam general je, tapi sebab now kita kan tengah in the middle of pandemic. But at the same time, we can take advantage of our social media and virtual tour nak promote a certain place. Jadi kan Pak, saya nak tanya, Pak ada tak macam like nak promote satu like hidden places yang tak banyak orang tahu dekat Indonesia ni? Nak, macam ni nak take advantage lah of virtual tour ni. So that bila macam dah pandemik ni habis, orang akan datang ke tempat tu. Ada tak macam certain place yang Pak nak promote? Okay, thank you Pak.
Baik. Wah, ini that's a very good questions. Karena kami di ITLA sekarang we've been doing that.
Oh.
Yeah. Karena we don't have any outbound tour right now. Now kita lagi bekerja sama dengan university di Indonesia, tourism, with a hexahelix, yeah, government, media, and academy, gitu ya, business, and what else, community. Jadi with our experience traveling around the world, begitu, we help local government because the quality Jakarta and other region in Indonesia is different. Yeah. For example, 2 months ago, the team from ITLA, from the research and development, we visit the place is we call it Bumi Ayu. Ibu Rosni ikut, ya, yeah, Mr. Rosni ikut ke Bumi Ayu. It's a place, yeah, where it's okay, from manusia purba, the old Sundanese peoples from that area. Even the government, that area usually only people only pass through only. But ITLA saw the potential of that area. We visit that place. We overnight there. We help the locals over there.
Oh.
Yeah. Besides as a tour leader, we become a surveyor. Like our experience in Danau Toba, we applied to other area.
Mm.
Now the request. So we do like a transfer skill from a tour leader, urban tourist guide tour leader, to surveyor and product development, destinations development in tourism. So guys, we cannot be only in one professions. We have to enrich ourselves. This pandemic, yeah, the lockdown is the golden potential for us to develop ourselves. So we not only the tourism. That's why I transfer skill from tourist guide to leader to be a surveyor, product development. In Indonesia, we have a lot of potentials. Now ITLA is invited to develop Jambi. So Jambi is a province, area in West Java, one in Central Java, the next one is in South Sulawesi. Yeah. So that's if you say the potentials, that's what we're doing. And one of it is doing a virtual tour. Do promotions.
Mm.
Oh wow, Bumi that's Ayu ya Pak.
Bumi Ayu.
Bumi Ayu.
Okay, it's we call it Kampung Purba.
Kampung Purba.
Purba, gitu ya. Ya Kampung Purba we call it. Purba is like a Jurassic, like that. Yeah.
Itu kalau virtual tour di sana, di mana ya kita boleh cari, Pak? The list of it. Ada lain-lain atau ada satu website yang kita bisa access semua?
Sementara ini belum ada ininya, Bu. Belum ada like association atau apa. It's masih scattered. So it's an individual.
Right.
Yeah. The big company usually they know that virtual tour only try to still engage with their clients. There is no tour, zero departure, gitu ya. So they give a virtual tour.
Tapi kalau di bawah ministry kita ada satu section juga, di bawah ministry website itu kita ada satu section, itu juga bagus juga, ya Pak?
Bisa juga, gitu. Nah, that's tapi kan now the government is concentrating on mengatasi pandemi kan.
Recovery, okay.
Recovery first. Yeah, it's not a priority one. So kita from associations, from ITLA, doing what Iqbal tadi ada idenya bagus. Ternyata kita sehati ya.
Yeah.
Kita lakukan.
Serupun, Bapak.
Big change daily life, culture, understanding. Gitu ya.
Okay, betul tuh Bapak.
Ya, yeah, itu. Iqbal.
Jawab tak Iqbal soalnya.
Thank you, Iqbal.
Ya. Menjawab Pak lebih panjang lagi. Terima kasih Pak.
Iqbal.
Thank you, Iqbal.
Okay, kita ada lagi satu soalan ke?
Nak tanya.
Okay, boleh. Siapa nak? Aina.
Aina.
Hi Aina.
Hi Aina.
Hello. Hello Bapak Bob. Hello Madam. Yeah. Organizing team. saya wakilkan tanya kawan saya Habibah sebab dia keluar masuk so dia nak tanya lah. So okay, soalan dia, virtual tour ni memang kena license tour guide sahaja yang boleh buat atau anyone yang boleh? Macam kami kan tourism students, jadi kami mau apa macam nak sharpen our tour guiding skills, but we don't have that experience due to the pandemic, right? So kalau kita orang, kami yang nak jadi virtual tour guide ni, boleh ke tak boleh? Kalau boleh, then ada skills or any tips that we should develop?
Yeah.
Okay. Nah, itu pertanyaan yang bagus. Pertanyaan bagus sekali. Karena kalau bagi saya, karena virtual tour ini baru, ya sangat baru sekali. Ya, kita harus lihat regulations-nya di Malaysia bagaimana, di Indonesia. Di Indonesia belum ada regulations-nya. Belum ada untuk virtual tour. Ya, belum ada virtual tour. Di Malaysia kalau memang belum ada ini, ya saya rasa it's part of creativity. You can do it. Seperti itu. About technically untuk tourist guide-nya, saya nggak tahu kalau misalnya apakah di campus ada course ya tourist guide atau dari Malaysian Tourist Guide Association apakah punya pelatihan seperti itu, gitu ya. Kalau kami di ITLA, gitu ya, we are proactive to campus. If you need a training atau apa, gitu ya, they can ask ITLA and we already provide the model storytelling. For about 7 days.
Right.
Yeah, 7 days. Seperti itu. Saya tidak tahu. Tapi kalau technically guiding, Anda bisa belajar. Tapi kalau license is about regulations. Depends on local. But I don't think that the fifth filter right now, it's about creativity. So you can learn.
There is no specific requirements yet lah.
No specific requirement.
Yeah,
boleh
kalau nak jadi virtual tour guide.
Kalau bagi saya sih
boleh, tapi bagi saya juga, I think you guys should be the pioneer lah. You can initiate licensing juga in the future. Yeah, you can initiate that, and maybe it's your time kan. So you boleh juga set up the regulation and propose to the government. We want all virtual tours to be licensed, and these are the outline. So you can propose that, and then later on, this will be more orang kata monitored, you know. So we can actually jaga the quality lah.
Okay, mengerti. Terima kasih ya, Pak.
Yeah. Okay, Aina, you can work on the module. I expect it by the end of the month. Thank you.
Okay, kita ada lagi soalan dari Izzati Bahaudin.
Izzati, yeah. Ini Queen of Toba ini. Mana dia?
Namanya familiar sekali.
Namanya familiar sekali. Mana
hello.
Ini
Izzatinya?
Hello, Pak Bob. Hello, Madam Azin. Hello, everyone.
Hi. Bukannya mana tuh? Kamu di mana nih?
Aktris.
Office.
Ya, seperti
Korean
aktris
drama.
Ya.
Yes, like Korean art actress.
Annyeong, annyeong.
Annyeong, annyeonghaseyo.
Pak Bob.
Ya, yeah, Izzati.
Saya ada soalan. What makes a good virtual tour? And usually how much does a virtual tour cost?
Okay. Jadi, kalau quality-nya, kita bicara quality tadi, ya bicara tentang cost-nya. Gitu. The regular one, ya, yeah, it's a... because teman saya itu dia udah tour leader, tourist guide, jadi quality-nya hal storytelling-nya sudah bagus. Dia belajar sedikit tentang broadcasting, angle, color, background, apa. Terus kemudian with production cost-nya dia sudah informasikan kepada saya one episode itu kurang lebih 1.5 hours in Indonesia ya, cost-nya sekitar dia keluarkan with the team sekitar 6 million rupiah. production cost. Rupiah, not,
itu not sama with the equipment, ya? RM.
Ya, jadi for example, the editors, the cameraman, lighting, gitu ya, itu per episode, gitu. Equipmentnya, ya, dia dia pakai sewa orang punya.
Itu 6 juta atau 6 miliar tuh, Pak?
6 juta. 6 juta buat 6 cost-nya juta. Saja. Jadi, seperti itu.
6 ya. Juta lebih kurang 2.000 ringgit lah ya?
Ya, mm-hmm. Per episode. Tapi itu zoom in the very good quality ya. Kalau mau yang versi murah, tanpa ya mengabaikan yang namanya copyright atau apa, saya bisa ambil dari Google, dari YouTube, saya combine gitu ya. Itu jagoan orang broadcasting gitu. Bisa saja, tapi perhatikan copyright-nya. Kamu harus ingin bawa courtesy of YouTube begitu. Tapi itu akan membuat kualitas dari virtual tour Anda credibility-nya kurang bagus. Karena kamu mempergunakan walaupun ini. Tapi kalau virtual tour yang benar namanya virtual. You have to go to the place. Banyak sekarang orang yang melakukan virtual tour never been to that place.
Right.
Never been to Paris, never been to Niagara Falls, never been to Rome. So they only give the information from Wikipedia.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nah, itu di dalam etika mass media communications itu namanya falsi, itu palsu. Nah, itu kode etik itu yang belum diatur oleh misalnya asosiasi begitu. That's why we want to be a professions, ya harus ada itu. Jadi production cost-nya the good one, ini good quality one is about 6 million in rupiah gitu ya.
Yeah.
Tapi kalau misalnya ya he's a professional tapi dia boyfriend saya mau kerjain ya monggo. Bonus lagi enggak sampai 2.000 ringgit kurang lebih.
Iya.
Gitu. Yeah. Itu kurang lebih. Tapi ya kalau menurut saya sih ya kalau di ringgit tadi sekitar 2.000 ringgit ataupun ini yang professional one deh. Saya bilang professional one. Kalau kamu mau buat sesuatu yang bagus tanpa perlu dibayar dan ini bisa reduce automatically. Jelas sih, Santi?
Jelas.
Alright. Thank you, Pak Bo.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you so much guys yang bertanyakan soalan kepada Bapak Bob kita. Ha,
betul.
Mesti ramai yang mendapatkan apa orang kata benda baru yang kita belajar daripada Bapak Bob. Ya, kadang ada yang kita tak tahu.
Ya, betul. Jadi, betul sekali Aida.
Banyak sangat info-info yang kita dapat daripada Bapak Bob ni sekarang.
Yes, ya, boleh nampak ya daripada bilangan participant yang bertanyakan soalan kepada Bapak Bob. Nampak ya kita punya participant sangatlah curious about our virtual tour today ya.
Betul.
Kalau kita sambung lagi soalan ni, mungkin kita boleh sambung sampai malam ya, madam?
Ya. Kita ada session sampai malam. Ya, nanti Bapak Bob charge ya. Lepas pukul 5:30 Bapak Bob akan charge 1 minit RM100 ya.
Oh my
God. Ya. Benar. Okay, kita back to the host.
Okay, terima kasih kepada our panel dan juga moderators kita ni, Ashikin, Aida dan juga Alisa. Banyak betul perkara dan juga ilmu yang kita belajar pada hari ini, Nabila.
Ya, betul. Atira, terlalu banyak ilmu yang kita tak tahu. Kita cuma tahu tentang virtual tour saja. Kita hanya tahu dasar dia. Kita tak pernah lagi mendalami ilmu virtual tour. Sebab itulah apa yang Bapak Bob cakap ni, terlalu banyak maklumatnya kan? Yeah, maklumat barunya melimpah ruah.
Saya pun baru tahu yang sebenarnya virtual tour ini dikendalikan oleh apa ni, broadcaster dan juga professional virtual tour ni sangat banyak bezanya. So jadi sebelum kita penghujung acara, kita mau dengar sedikitlah kata daripada panel kita ni, Bapak Bob.
Yeah.
Terima kasih buat rekan-rekan. Di Indonesia saya juga mengajar tentang MICE.
MICE?
MICE, event organizer. Dan di ujian terakhirnya juga melakukan event seperti yang teman-teman lakukan pada saat ini.
Wow.
Jadi sambil belajar juga.
Gitu dijemput ya. Juga Pak kami, yes. Kami juga mau mau ikutin.
Mau. Jadi, gak mau ketinggalan.
Ya. Kebetulan di certified, saya juga certified event organizer dan punya perusahaan sendiri ya, rekan-rekan.
Alhamdulillah.
Tapi apa yang teman-teman lakukan pada saat ini dan persiapannya luar biasa.
Terima kasih. Ya.
Kalau saya punya otoritas untuk memberikan nilai, saya pasti kasih nilainya bagus-bagus.
Alhamdulillah.
Oh. Nilainya jelek. Ini ya.
Tapi
jujur
medem ikhlas dari hatinya.
Jadi saya tidak pernah melihat kalau misalnya ini hanya hasil akhir, tapi the process itu yang perlu teman-teman perhatikan. Saya yakin juga Pon Aswin melihat prosesnya nih. Nggak ada yang langsung bagus seperti itu. Nggak. Prosesnya benar apa enggak? Kalaupun hasil akhirnya bagus, tapi prosesnya salah, nanti tidak terpakai di dunia profesional. Ini fungsi Pon Aswin sebagai advisor adalah membimbing teman-teman. Ini prosesnya ini loh, seperti ini. Creativity silakan, tapi kan kadang-kadang creativity-nya itu beyond apa melewati batas gitu. Nggak boleh. Ada aspek etisnya seperti ini. Dan saya melihat apa yang rekan-rekan lakukan dengan PD Tech Series 3.0 ini dari awal sampai akhir dan persiapannya luar biasa. Keren.
Thank you, Bob.
Thank you, Bapak Bob, for your nice sentiment. Give a big applause to our Bapak Bob.
Thank you, Bapak.
We also hope that everyone can learn something new about virtual tour today, as this can be an alternative tourism for those who are unable to do vacation.
Benar tu, Tu Nabila. Ah, tadi kita dah dengar sepatah dua kata daripada Bapak Pop kan? Now we would like to hear a few words from our lovely madam.
Oh. Thank you. Annyeong.
Annyeong.
Okay. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. First of all, thank you to our panel speaker, Bapak Bob Monica, my very funny friend ya daripada sana, because I followed his tour before and I regretted because I couldn't stop laughing. Yeah, he's always like making funny jokes of everything, which actually sometimes jokes helps you to remember moments. Yeah. So itu I think kelebihan tour guide juga. Jadi tour guide ini dia bisa kalau tengok moodnya turun, dia naikkan semula. Kalau hilang semangatnya, naik lagi. Jadi ini kelebihan Bapak Bob. Dan setelah after I spoke to him regarding this topic, you know, he was very sporting enough and very kind enough to agree to work with us. So I would like to applaud you for this, Bapak Bob. Please give Bapak Bob a big hand. Terima kasih. Semoga kita boleh membalas jasa baik Bapak Bob, insyaAllah. Ya.
Insyaallah.
And of course, like the session today, there's so many things we learn. Yeah. So this PD Talk series is really about professional development. So one of the objective is to, of course, find opportunities in the future of career development of the current student. And if I think some of the questions were very, very good, sangat berkualiti, and it all comes back to us whether we could actually consider this as a career. There are a lot we can do in regards to virtual tours, definitely, because the potential is there. The potential is there, but not many people want to probably take the initiative yet. But I think it is in the process. Yeah, like Bapak Bob mentioned, many independent companies or independent individual people are actually working on their own creativity, coming up with their own production. Yeah, so when these trend, yeah. When this trend becomes something more significant in our society, I'm sure we can actually attract the attention of the authority, more, maybe more support from the ministry and stuff like that. And I believe, yeah, virtual tour will not end when the pandemic is end. This is how I see it. Personally, I think there is a big future in virtual tour. There are many, many ways we could actually use virtual tour as our tools, day-to-day tools, and in how we can actually see the world in the future, because we will never know how people see the world in the future. Dulu yang bilang ada kereta terbang, jadi kita masih menunggu kereta terbangnya, ya. Tapi
tidak ada lagi.
Iya, jadi we cannot really see, but we can always predict. But I'm sure there is a lot of benefit and apa that we can gain from sessions like this. And we can open our eyes sekarang in order to probably grab the opportunity. So this is a good opportunity for you guys to learn. So yes. Congratulations to my organizing team. Yeah. For putting this together. Excellent work on the topic, because it is not an easy topic, ya Pak. Teman-teman, this is one of the most challenging topic juga sebenarnya, kerana itu banyak researchnya masih macam, you know, ini benar atau enggak, you know, gitu kan. Jadi banyak yang uncertain. Jadi it's a very challenging journey. So of course, virtual tour has everything to do with the current tourism sector that is being hit badly by the pandemic, so the relation is pretty close. So but these students really learn a lot from this this topic, definitely. And thank you to all participants dari Indonesia, dari sini semua. Until the end juga ada almost 100 lagi participant, ya. So obviously the talk is very engaging. Especially the contoh-contoh yang kita lihat tadi kan, London, Niagara Falls. Actually, I wanted to request for more. Macam, wow, I want to see more, because I kind of miss the vibe, you know, of being in these places. And I'm sure teman-teman yang belum pernah ke sana pasti mau terbang terus nih kalau pandemic over, sudah sampai di KLIA, sudah ya, semua mau terbang ya. Jadi, betul-betul tour ini hanya kita gunakan sebagai satu platform untuk kita lebih kenali tempat itu sebelum kita pergi. So yang bapak-bapak bilang tadi itu is like information before we go to the place. So because we cannot actually apply all the senses in virtual tour, but the knowledge is also very important. The knowledge exchange. Yeah. So again, congratulations to PD Talk Series 3.0 this time. And I would like to take this opportunity untuk minta maaf sekiranya ada salah dan silap from all of us. Thank you again, Bapak Bob, Monica. I hope to work with you again in the future.
Yes, thank you.
Back to you guys, host. Thank you.
Thank you so much, madam, for your nice sentiment.
Yes, and on behalf of my team, once again, I would like to apologize for any inconvenience. Kami juga nak memohon maaf kepada Bapak Bob and Puan Win, dan juga kepada partisipan jika ada tersilap kata atau tersalah bahasa daripada kami. Terima kasih juga kepada Bapak Bob kerana sudi menyertai our PD Talk Series. We are very grateful and honored that Bapak Bob can took the time off of your schedule to join our PD Talk event. Terima kasih ya Bapak Bob. Dan
Terima kasih semua.
Terima kasih Bapak Bob. Terima kasih
semua. Pamit ya.
Okay, thank you.
Terima kasih
yang sanggup luangkan masa bersama kami.
Terima kasih.